whistles, this is the real thing. So after 83 years in the Football League, Swansea's future, depending on the next 83 minutes plus 10 or so.
Take me back to that day here, 10 years ago. You know, just before kick off, and you know what's at stake. What was going through your mind?
I just remember the build up for the week being so intense. Everywhere you went in Swansea, supporters, anywhere, you know, not even just Swansea supporters, everyone talking about the game you can't lose, you have to win. Swansea can't drop out of the Football League, and then the day arrives, and you're nervous. Obviously, you can feel the tension, how different this game is compared to any other game. And you just want to get the job done. You just want to win that game and just do it for the fans. So you go into it very nervous, but you know, you're hoping that you get the result.
Somebody was saying that Roger Freeston couldn't stand still. He was pacing up and down with a cup of tea in his hand.
Yeah, he was. I think obviously he was sub that day, Roger. And Roger being at the club for many years, played so many games for the football club. Apparently he was up and down the touchline. He couldn't sit still. He was in the changing room. He was a nervous wreck, you know. So it was great to have someone like him around the club at the time, because, you know, it meant so much for him.
And you were new in at the club. I mean, you were in on loan. I mean, young as well. I mean, that must have felt such a weight of responsibility on your shoulders.
Yeah, a little bit, but I think it did help that I was young. You know, I went into the game. And that season, just wanting to play football, you know, just so enthusiastic. Didn't really think of the consequences, to be honest. Maybe more of the lads who was at the club under contract with mortgages to play and been there for a long time, it was a bit different for them. But for me, being a young lad, I just wanted to get out there and play, and just, I didn't concentrate on the consequences and what it meant, really. It was just, I just wanted to play, do well and try and get the result for the team.
And it was the fairy tale ending, I mean, because you'd gone down, you know, a couple of goals down, and then come back to win it 4-2. It was a fairy tale ending to what had been a huge drama.
Yeah, it was. Obviously, we started the game pretty well. We went 1-0 up, and before you know it, we're 2-1 down, and the atmosphere just, you could just hear a pin drop in the ground. But fortunately, we got a penalty just before half-time. It went 2-2. 3-2 pretty soon after half time, and then James Thomas rounds off his hat trick with a wonderful chip on about 70 minutes, and then I think the game was done. Then we just, you know, I can't remember how many times I asked the ref how long left. It was like, I think all of us were screaming at him, you know, and you know, once the fourth goal went, it was game over and could relax a little bit more.
And was it right that he was saying to you, literally, I'm just about to blow up now, you're going to have to get off this pitch pretty quickly because you'll be mobbed?
Yeah, he did. I think it was a corner we got, and he went over to Kevin Nugent and Roberto, I think it was, and said, look, I'm going to blow this whistle, pick up the ball and you get into the tunnel. The tunnel's pretty tight at the Vetch. But unfortunately, I got caught up in the melee of the fans running on, and I was a bit nervous at the time because everyone's trying to rip your boots off, your socks, your shorts, your shirt. So I was a bit nervous, but no, it was great scenes. It was just great to see the relief on all the supporters' faces.
Yeah, and I mean, a huge response from the city afterwards. I mean, you'd been the saviours of a city. I mean, if Swansea had dropped out of the Football League, it would have dire for the city, really, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would have been. It was, you know, the football club in many communities play a massive part. For us to get that result, stay in the Football League was key, and since then, it's been the catalyst for us, really, as a football club. It was the kick up the backside we needed. We didn't want to be in that situation again. And you've got to give credit to the board, obviously local businessmen, fans, if you like, took over and have made many great decisions along the way, and it's ended up with us being in the Premier League where we are today.
And looking back now, this is the site of the old Vetch. I mean, you know, it must evoke so many memories still when you come back down here. I know we've got allotments and benches and things like that here now, but there's still a spirit about this place, isn't there?
No, it is. It's great that you can still walk through, you know, like you've got the supporters of this club, we've got great memories of the Vetch. You can still come here, you can see the centre circle there, you've still got the Swan over where the North Bank used to be, so it's still fantastic that, you know, a lot of other clubs probably just do the building work on there and put apartments and bits on there, but it's still nice to be able to wander through here. For me, it holds special memories because this is the place where I made my Football League debut as such, you know, my debut season, so I'll always look back with fond memories here.
And I wonder about the fact that you guys survived that, you survived that ultimate drop. I wonder whether that has stood you in good stead now for the rest of your career, and particularly in the top flight now, the three seasons you've been in the top flight, that you almost feel if you've survived this, you can survive anything.
Well, yeah, the pressure's different back then. Obviously, you have pressure in the Premier League, but back then, it was people's mortgages, people's lives, you know, that was on the table and that game. So it was a great experience, especially for me being 20 years old, my debut years in the Football League, to play a game like that. It can only help, you know, so I'm very obviously thankful for Swansea for giving me the opportunity, and that game has helped me in the years gone by.
If you could jump into a time machine and go back to that day, would you?
Yeah, I would. I would like to go back. You know, you watch the DVDs and the video footage of it, and at the time it's a bit of a blur, you know. It happens and you get lost in the moment a bit. But I'd love to go back and relive that day. It was a fantastic day and one that's gone down in Swansea's history.
Yeah, certainly has. Great memories.
Yeah, very good.
Yeah, thanks, Leo.
Swansea's players return to take the plaudits of the crowd.
Bearing in mind what's gone before, what happened 10 years ago, what was it like to be here at the Liberty Stadium running out as a Premier League player?
No, it was a great moment for us. I think for everyone involved in the football club, you could feel it with the fans, you know, the players, the board, you know, the whole city. It was a massive occasion, and to run out in the Premier League, the biggest league in the world, at the Liberty Stadium playing for Swansea was a great occasion for everyone involved.
Could you ever have imagined, bearing in mind what had happened before, that you'd have got to that point? I mean, obviously third season in the Premier League now, I mean, you're well established, but does it sometimes seem as though it's all a little bit of a dream?
Yeah, I think if you're honest, we wouldn't dream we'd be in the Premier League 8 or 9 years ago. Like you say, we're in our third year now, we're doing well again. But at the time, 9 years ago, the Premier League seems a million miles away. You know, you're only concentrating on trying to get out of maybe League Two. Then you get there and you think about trying to get out of League One, and then it progresses, and then all of a sudden you're in the Championship and you're thinking one good season we can get there. So it is a bit of a blur, if you like. It's been such a roller coaster ride in the last 8 or 9 years, but you know, it's been very enjoyable.
And what are you anticipating from Hull, the Hull of the Premier League, albeit they're new boys?
Oh, a very tough test. I think they've settled in to the Premier League very well, picked up some very impressive results. Like any team coming up, we was like that 2 or 3 years ago. You're fighting for your life, you're fighting in every game for every point because you want to be there. You work so hard to get to the Premier League, you don't want it to be one season and dropping back into the Championship. So, you know, obviously they've got quality players. We know Danny Graham, obviously, very well ourselves. So I think they've started pretty well in the Premier League. So it's going to be a tough game.
Do you think it'll evoke any memories of them? I mean, I know you've faced them since. You've faced them in lower divisions, but bearing in mind it is 10 years since that day now, you know, and I know it was back in May, but, you know, it's the 10th anniversary, really. Do you think it'll evoke memories? Do you think that will throw it up again between, you know, yourselves and Hull, albeit there might not be any of their players still around from that time?
Yeah, I think it will a little bit. I think because this game's being played in the Premier League, like I say, May 2003, both of us were in the bottom division, obviously ourselves having to win to stay in the Football League. We have played each other over the years, but in the lower divisions, whereas now both teams are in the Premier League. So it just shows how far, you know, both clubs have come really in a short space of time. So it will evoke memories. I think they've talked about maybe trying to get the Swansea team we played that day. I don't know if they can drag Roberto down from Everton, but it'd be great to see the players that was involved in that game, because without that team and winning that day, we wouldn't be in the Premier League where we are now.
And James Thomas should have a place in a hospitality box somewhere, shouldn't he?
I don't think Tomo's probably bought a drink since in Swansea since that game.
Too.
Yeah, and rightly so. I mean, obviously, a local boy, what a legend, you know, to score a hat-trick to keep us up. And like I say, I mean, it was his day and obviously a great day for Swansea, but for the local boy to do that, it just couldn't get no better.
What about Brian Flynn? Do you think he'll be here for the match?
Yeah, I think Brian will be here, yeah. You know, obviously Brian's a local lad, Port Talbot, I think, so he's back and forth. I recently met with him, actually, about a month or so ago, so he's always about the area, and I'm sure that he was the manager. I mean, I'm sure he's going to get the phone call to come, and he'll enjoy it, and it'll be a great night for everyone, you know, involved from that game to step out on the pitch, and, you know, they didn't get to play at the Liberty Stadium, a lot of them, so they'll get to feel the roar of the Liberty.
How about you as a player, the Leon Britton of that time, sort of helping Swansea survive and stay in the Football League, to the Leon Britton of now? How have you changed? How have you grown?
Well, I haven't grown. I know that. I haven't grown.
You mean it literally?
I've lost a bit of pace. The bit of pace I did have, I've lost, but.
I don't think you have, you know.
You don't think?
No, not at all.
I don't know. Maybe I've got quicker in my head, but I feel I've improved as a player over the last 10 years. When I first come to Swansea, I was 20 years old. I was someone who wanted to get the ball and do tricks and try and beat players. And, you know, in the whole game, I won a penalty in that game. And that's what I was, you know. I was trying to get in the opposition penalty area. But since then, I've become a holding midfielder. So my role's changed in the team. But I feel I've improved. I think as the team's improved through the years, I think you had to try and improve. Otherwise, you get left behind. You know, I've seen a lot of players over the years who've done well in one division. But unfortunately, you go up and you know they get left behind. So I feel that I've improved. I've got better, and I'm hoping that there's still a few more years left in my legs.
I think there's left in you, yeah, Grandad, very, very definitely. The complexion of that midfield has changed, though, hasn't it? I mean, you were playing pretty much with homegrown players when you were fighting for that Football League survival. It's very much more a continental feel to things these days. I know you're not comparing like with like, but I guess both have got their advantages. Both perhaps have got their drawbacks.
Yeah, I think. When you go away to Lincoln on a Tuesday night, I think you do need a base of British players when you go there. I mean, no disrespect to the foreign boys, but obviously they're very good technically. But Lincoln away or Cambridge or somewhere very far on a cold Tuesday night is where you need the British players. But like you say, now the Premier League is such a multinational league. We're a prime example. We've got so many players from all over the world, but fantastic players, you know, technically. And it's great to be a part of them, seeing them, you know, and playing alongside of them and training with them. It's great. But like I say, it is different because in League Two, I don't think we had, I don't even know if we had one foreign player. I'm not sure, we'll have to have a look. But the base of the team was a lot of local boys as well, which was nice.
Yeah. You certainly didn't need any Spanish then, did you? Or only to talk to Roberto?
No, you didn't need that. No, Roberto was the only one, to be fair. That's why he kept taking us to the Spanish restaurant all the time. So I picked up a bit of Spanish.
Bearing in mind what happened that day, I mean, you went a goal up by that penalty, which you earned for them. Two goals down then, or two goals came back in very quick succession for Hull. I mean, you know, can you see it panning out in a similar sort of way in the Premier League?
I'd take 4-2. I'd definitely take a win, but no, I mean, that game was exciting, weren't it? I mean, if you had a replica of that game, I think everyone from the Swansea side, obviously, would be very happy, but... Oh, I don't know if it'll be that kind of scoreline. I mean, like I say, that day had so much going for it. Two penalties, a hat-trick, obviously with us staying up. But I think it'll be a bit tight this time in the Premier League. I think both teams will be needing the points, obviously ourselves and Hull. But I don't know if it'll be 4-2. But like I say, if we come out of the winners, I'll take a 1-0.
And this place will be buzzing because the whole city was just so grateful to you guys for that survival in the Football League. I mean, you know, to see the rematch here is the crowd are going to be buzzing, aren't they?
Yeah, of course they are. The crowd are always fantastic down at this stadium. I think any opposition player would tell you it's an intimidating atmosphere here. And like you say, they won't need lifting for that. I mean, obviously they'll remember the game and the significance of the whole match in 2003. So they'll be really up for that game, and I'm sure it'll be a great atmosphere.
Just touching away from Hull for the moment, obviously there's that trip to Norwich that you've got coming up. I mean, how are you feeling about that? I mean, Norwich really under fire at the moment. I mean, they really need points, don't they?
Yeah, and obviously they've been a bit of talk about the manager being under pressure there, but you know, they got a good win at home against West Ham recently, which was a good result for them. But again, I think in the Premier League, you've got the top seven or eight clubs who are always going to be there. And then there's a group of us below that, really, who you can have a good season, you can finish in the top 10. You know, you have a poor season, you can finish in the bottom three. So Norwich, obviously a team in that league with us, maybe not have had the best of starts, but we haven't had a really good time at Carroll Road, to be honest, since we've come to the Premier League. So we'll go there trying to get a win, because we haven't done that since we've come up.
Best of luck with both. Really hope you get them.
Cheers, thank you.
Thank you, Liam.